they are kind of away from each other, so we might be able to take out one each time. Famous last words. Let's try to approach on this corner here. Welcome back, my friends, to another episode of Imperium Galactic Survival. We are playing Project Eden Alpha 11. Let's continue from where I left off, and it's still nighttime where I have parked my capital vessel. We are here at Rator, a very large planet. And when I say very large, it's clearly, clearly very large. For today's episode, we are going to keep exploring. It's a very large planet, and I want to uncover a little bit more of this planet. And for that, today's episode is going to be a little bit focused on exploring, but in exploring with a twist. We are playing with volume 1, volume it's old news. We are playing also with CPU requirements on, so I don't have those components that you need for crafting tier 3 and above hover vessels and small vessels, so we are stuck to tier 2 and tier 1. We have here MCRN Talon tier 2, so you can, if you want, you can search it on the workshop and you will download this model. I have played with it last episode. I have just repaired because it was it took a couple of hits from a turret, from a POI, from a Zyrax POI, and I had to repair it. And it's kind of boring repair, and of course because I need to know what kind of parts to place so that I repair it correctly. So for today's episode, I'm going to try one thing. I have added a polarized hull shield, and if you go to control panel, CPU statistics, by adding a polarized hull shield, which has this crazy amount. When I say crazy, I'm not complaining, it's what it is. So it has this value, 16,300 points of that goes into CPU tier statistics, which means that we are now on the efficiency level half, almost 50%. But since my exploring on my today's episode, I want to explore, and if we find nice POIs, we might assault them, or depending on which POIs I'm going to find. For me, the polarized hull shield, it's going to be mandatory. So I hope everything goes according to plan. It is noticeable. I'm real main power on. Let me just turn on the thrusters and the weapons. It's noticeable moving. I'm trying to steer right and steer left, and it's much more bulkier. It feels like we are almost flying a capital vessel, but I don't mind that for this episode because I want to have a shield working. I don't know if it's going to work correctly, whatnot. When I get some shots in, hopefully it will protect my ship. But I know I'm traveling slower, it will move slower, but I hope the shield, it will be a benefit for today's episode. A lot of traveling and exploring. Wow, such a nice sunrise, amazing. A lot of exploring, but if I run across some drones, we have here the bigger drones on this planet. I think it's safer for me, even if I take some shots. The added benefit of the shield, it will offset the bulkier movement of my small vessel. And of course, I will, since it's a lot of exploring, I will do a lot of flying. I will try to make it with a little bit of editing after recording the video. It's not going to be boring for you guys, but for me it's going to be better, even if I use more time exploring. So guys, let's explore a little bit more the map. Look at this. I don't know how many hours, if not real-time days, I will need to explore all of this. But let's explore a little bit more, because I'm looking forward to it. We know I have uncovered a couple of POIs. We are playing Alpha 11, Project Eden, and all of these POIs for me, well, not the submerged tank, but the missile base, the ice storm defense, all of them are new to me, so I'm really looking forward for a lot of exploring. So that's what I will do today. So let's start. And we found a cobalt deposit, a medium one. Nice. I will do a lot of exploring, a lot of video editing, so that it keeps the video, it keeps a fast pace. And hopefully, if I engage in any combat, the shield is going to be useful. I have some rockets, right? Let's reload the rockets. We have, okay. And some bullets. We brought some bullets. Very nice. So let's start exploring. Approaching our first POI of today's episode. Sorry for the weather, my friends. Heavy snow as usual. Lousy weather. When I am flying, I see four drones, four heavy drones. And what can I please mark the POI on my map? Let's see. Oxygen distribution hub. Yeah, it's following the collection of POIs that I don't know. And we have a lot to the west. So this should be a cluster of POIs, of Zarg's POIs. Let's see if we can, without approaching too much, if we can uncover most of them. Seeing more drones over there. Why can't I get a clear weather? At least I'm seeing two POIs, tower defense. Let's be fair, three POIs, snowstorm defense. Looks menacing. Another snowstorm defense. Communications center level 3. Wow, I see at least three more. Let's try to. Strange. Yeah, strange, no. If I am a little bit higher, I can see a little bit better. Promethium refinery. So nice supply station. And oxygen depot. And they are shooting me. I'm seeing some. Yep. They are shooting, but they are missing. Okay, yeah, 98%. Okay. So the shield does work. That was the reason why I placed it. 95%. Yeah. I have a shield. I have a shield. Okay. So we have uncovered this cluster of. Wow. Well, it looks like a flower on the map. Let me just move away a little bit. Fly south. What we have here? Well, I'm not going to be here soon because it would be crazy. I have to remove all of those defenses. And it's not going to be on this Tier 2 small vessel. Hopefully, we'll find some POIs which are kind of on the side that we can approach, destroy the patrols, and do a good ground assault. If I'm lucky, I might find some of those alien POIs which are smaller. They also have some rare containers. And if we were lucky enough to find one of those, and if I was able to loot the containers, perhaps we can get what we need for building our first Tier 3 small vessel. Or hover vessel, whatever. But I think it's. If I have limited resources in terms of vessels, I might prefer for the first one to be like a heavy assault fighter small vessel. To be able to take out all of those POIs, because after that it's going to be easier to get the rare resources to build an HV. So let's keep exploring. Zyrax territory again. Looks like it's. Just one POI, which is the ones that I like. How many turrets? I see one, just one drone. What kind of... Well, but it's a... Oxygen distribution hub. How many turrets? One, two... Whoa. Yeah. One, but I'm seeing so many drones. Yeah, and I cannot almost, I'm trying to move sideways. We are with 46% of performance in our small vessel. Whoa, ow. Let's go away. I'm seeing more drones over there. 74, 71, 70%. Okay. This is the big offset. You are using a shield, you move much slower, so you'll take more shots. What are you protecting? Perhaps you are protecting a deposit. You see, let's go fly above this drone. Setting deposit large, nice. I have already found several deposits, so that's really, really nice. And we have here a crash capital vessel. In the weather update, we are now on light snow. I hope before the end of the episode we will be on clear skies. Another Xyrox site. What's that? A missile base, I think it is. Let's hear the bling. Missile base. I think it's the third one that I found today. Some abandoned buildings, which I don't know even if they are going to be marked on the map. Nope, they are just... Okay, they are shooting me. You can shoot me whatever you want. I have the shields. So, map. Yeah, missile base, and oxygen distribution hub. Let's keep flying. The planet is so huge that I think the daylight, the time of the daylight is 16 hours. Look like it. The logistics terminal. Can we take a closer look at the logistics terminal? Let's try. Let me move. Oof. I cannot almost move to the left or right. Okay, so let's do it the good old way, which is with the forward thrusters and a lot of moving my mouse. Okay, back away. I'm not seeing any drones, so that's a good news, and I'm counting four turrets. I might be wrong, but they are kind of away from each other, so we might be able to take out one each time. Famous last words, right? Famous last words. Let's try to approach on this corner here. One that I did not notice, this one here. There we go. Oops, no, one more. And last one. Nice. So. I'm seeing. Whoa. I'm seeing some Xyrax patrols on the ground. Another patrol over there. Okay, but well, someone is shooting from the top. Oh, it's the sentry guns over there. Okay. Nice. They don't damage a lot my shields, so nice. We are 97%. What the hell is shooting one over there? Okay, let's take them out while we are on our small vessel. Nice. And the last one. Wow. I see one. Last one? No, I see several. I see several. There you go. That one over there. Nice. And we have, perhaps we have one over there, over here. Let's try to move slowly to the side. And when I say slowly, it's really, really slowly. We should have one. Yeah, I'm seeing it. Seeing it. Come on. Okay. Oops. Oops. So hard. Well, this is the changes of the CPU, my friends. If you want good vessels, you should specialize and not do strange things like I do, which is kind of clump everything together as we did previous alphas. There you go. Okay. Now it looks like we are kind of alone, right? I don't see anyone shooting me. Any Zarax? Is there a Zarax over there? Yes, there it is. Sorry, you should not see that guy. Let's approach. There you go, smash in the face. Come on. Zarax rocket. Oh, ow. Zarax. Now they are hostile. Okay. Now they are hostile. Ooh, so many patrols. So many patrols. And someone is shooting me. Okay. First part of the assault has been done. Let's move into a safe place. I still have a little bit of fuel. Okay. Slowly, turn around. There it is. This is going to be our first assault. Is anyone shooting me? Yeah. Now if someone shoots me, I can hear them. Or can I? Can't I? Watching the shield. Yeah, okay. So this logistics terminal is going to be our first assault, level 7. But I might bring the support of my capital vessel, I think. And it's half the planet across. Where is my capital vessel? Over here. Waypoint. Come on. Waypoint. Except that it is my capital vessel, which is 21 kilometers to the west. So that's really, really a little bit far away. But next episode, perhaps we are going to assault this logistics terminal. We have taken out all of the external turrets. We have a shield in our capital vessel, so it's going to be easier, I think, to plan out my ground assault with the help of the capital vessel. It will help out in removing some of these external patrols, and of course I don't know the logistics terminal. I don't know if it's just what we are seeing here or if it is something it has underground levels or not. Usually these Zarax POIs, they are not that big. Well, I think for instance the drone factory, it is kind of a long one, but most of them, they are fairly standard and easy to complete, or at least they are not that long, comparing with the abandoned POIs, which they are pink and they usually have 2 to 3 underground levels besides the upper levels. So those ones like the abandoned mine, abandoned factory, abandoned drone base, abandon something, those ones it will take a while. So let's keep exploring. I will mark this POI here, the waypoint. There you go. So let's keep our theme of this episode, which is explore, and we have to eat something. Fridge, show me the fridge. Oops, fridge. I have here I brought a lot of fuel pack, so my goal was, didn't I bring, oh, what is the spoiled food? supposed to be steaks. But they spoiled. Why did they spoil? Strange. Strange, because I have my fridge on all the time. Remember, my current capital vessel does not have a farm area, so I'm kind of restricted on the food that I have. I have a lot of it, but I cannot grow more, at least until I or get a base going or move into a different capital vessel. But for now, or of course go out and hunt for more food, which I think in these snow planets, I haven't checked on this one yet, but the big lakes, you have a lot of, and you can kind of see it. Let's see. If you approach, you will see some plants that you can pick up, and they are plant proteins. But it's medium snow. Look at now. If you look at the water, you see those small. It looks like plants. If you pick them up, they will give you some plant proteins. And usually they are in the lakes. What do we have here? Okay, never mind. I thought it was just one, but I'm already seeing two POIs, so forget about it. Let's mark them and proceed. If it was just one, well, I'm seeing three. Support base, okay. Level 3, communication center, and what the hell is the other one? Drone base, perhaps? I don't recall this one here. Stop shooting me. Come on. I'm just seeing, sightseeing drone base. Yeah. We have here the drone base. Shoo, shoo, shoo. Leave me alone. Okay, and speaking about those, I think it is one of those. I think it's an abandoned drone base. Let's see. Come on. We are not inside any territory, so should be, yeah, abandoned drone base. These pink ones with that prefix ALN, alien POI. Those ones have a lot of goodies, but they are very long to explore, but really worth it. It's one of those favorite POIs that I really like to explore. Even if I don't remember the last time that I did the alien drone base. Abandoned mine, abandoned factory, but what's this? What is this? Oh, it's a Polaris. Unfortunately, I don't recall the correct name. Let's see if we go to the blueprints. Let me see. I have here a hover vessel that needs, I think it's this one here. These small optronic bridges, they can be bought at the trader. Unfortunately for us, even if this is a continuation of my Project Eden Alpha 10, Alpha 11, I haven't used the console to give me any faction points, so I need to build my reputation again, and to be able to trade with the Polaris, we need to be friendly. We are neutral. We are kind of 1,500 points until we are able to trade with them. But of course, shooting Zarax, it will give us some points to the Polaris, so it's just a matter of time. We have here the settlement. I don't know where those traders are, if they are in all Polaris settlements, if it is in the trading station on the in orbit. I don't know. I haven't yet searched a lot about it. I know that you can buy them. I don't know where you can find the traders, because it's something new in Alpha 11, and I'm playing Alpha 11 Project Eden with you guys. And it's also Alpha 11, because I have started a new game on Alpha 11, but all my experience in Alpha 11 is being recorded on video, and are into the night. Into the night, but at least light snow into the night with the moon right above the path to our capital vessel. It's a gorgeous sight. And it's kind of a not too dark night. I have seen worse in Imperium. Worse, of course, in terms of recording for YouTube. In terms of gameplay, playing during the night, I don't mind at all. But it kind of renders into a very, very dark video. Can I turn on the lights? Wow. Yeah, it's a little bit better. We have 11 minutes of fuel. Let's again go to my devices. Before, I have spent almost all of my fuel packs. Fuel. There you go. Come on. 33 left, so we should be heading home, and that's what we'll do. A lot of almost speechless in terms of real time while playing to record this YouTube video. I have been playing for I think 1 hour and 15 minutes, and look at this. We have just explored this. All awesome places to check, to see, to... It's mind-boggling the how big Imperium is going to be. And of course this project even makes it like 100 times bigger, because we are just in one of like 70 planets available on Project Eden. I could spend a lifetime over here on this planet. I don't need to go elsewhere. So it's going to be like Project Eden episode 532, and it's going to be, well, we are leaving Rator now. We are going to explore the next planet, because we have checked half the POIs here. It would be something like in that order of magnitude. Okay, and we have arrived at my at my nightclub, or as you say it, my capital vessel. Let's. Oops, come on. Please, Mr. Door, open up. Okay. And you can imagine the music, and let's dance a little bit. I might play some of those. I think you can buy some of them at the Polaris Station, some of those aliens, and we can really transform this hangar bay into a nightclub. Well, in terms of colors, we are spot on. Yeah, we just need some friends, and we'll have here a nice nightclub. Well, let's get back to business. Let's check what we have explored. Very nice, nice exploration. We are here. We went like this, over there, back, down here, turned around, up, and back. It was 1 hour and a half flying. Of course, we were flying slowly, but I'm playing with the hardest settings in terms of enemies. So if you have seen, I think last episode, we just took a shot to our right flank from a turret. It was just one, and it destroyed the light and the thruster. So I need the shield. Playing with the hardest settings, I need a shield, because if not, while exploring, I get distracted, I get shot, and it might be enough to render useless my small vessel, and then I will have to walk home. So I really need a shield. Of course, the offset is I'm going to move slower, I'm going to not be able to dodge as much, but I prefer the shield. So checking the map before ending the episode, we found several deposits. We have here a cobalt medium one, iron medium, satium large, very nice, iron again, satium large, cobalt medium, silicon small. We did not find any copper, no problem whatsoever. We have here our why is it okay, it is white because it's the waypoint. We have here our target for next episode. Next episode, it's going to be the approach with my capital vessel, clearing the patrols, and then assaulting the POI. So that's going to be nice. It will take a while, so that's why I decided to split into two episodes, because if not, it would be a very, very long just one episode. We have here a missile base, fuel depot, drone base, communication center, support base, a lot of them I do not know, oxygen distribution hub, settlement, yeah, that I know, oxygen distribution hub. We have here a cluster that I'm not going to get near. This cluster in the foreseeable future, but it's nice to know that they are here, that they are there, and that's pretty much it. I don't know if I'm going to explore more. If I will explore more, perhaps I will do it between episodes and show you the highlights at the beginning of the next one. Sorry for this long waffle at the end of the episode. For me, it was a very good one because it opens up on what I want to do on this planet. Let me know if you know these POIs on the comments, if you would like for me to assault them. I will probably, but I don't know them by heart, so there might be one of these, they might be amazing in terms of loot, and I don't know that, so I will start off on this one that I removed the turrets. But feel free to let me know in the comments if any of these are good POIs to assault. My friends, I hope you have enjoyed, and I hope you join me on the next one, where we will assault our first POI on this very large planet.